What's going on, everybody? It's ETA Prime back here again with another LaunchBox news video. Today, we're releasing LaunchBox 13.16 for Windows. And with this one, we've got some fixes, improvements, and some new features. And of course, I want to jump right into it with the new features. So first on the list being one of my favorites here, LaunchBox now offers save management capabilities. This is in early access, but you can automatically track and organize your save games and save states. Right now, this is only working with RetroArch, but with RetroArch, we've got a ton of different systems covered, and we are working on getting this up and running with other emulators down the road, so definitely keep an eye out. And basically, with this new feature, we can import multiple save files for the same game, and we can back them up. Plus, we've added new save game badges, so it's easy to kind of see exactly what games have saves in your system. And that's the first thing I want to take a look at here. So I'm in my All Games section, and the easiest way to show these badges is to head up right here, Badges, Game Attributes, Enable Has Save Game, Enable Has Save States. I've got save files for a bunch of different systems, so I'm just going to use the filter option here so we can see them. Game saves, has any saved game, has any save state. So this just went through my whole collection, found the games that have the save states, and you can see we've got a new badge system. Has saved game will be the blue disc icon. Has save state will be the black disc icon. So right here with Astro Boy, you can see I've got both. And if we want to back these up for our games, it's actually pretty simple. I'm just going to edit game, edit metadata and media. We've got a new section here, game saves. So you can see active saves. I've got a state and a game save. We can back it up right here. So choose OK. I'm going to back both of these up. Now that we've saved these, they're actually located in a new folder inside of our LaunchBox directory. So I've just backed up my save state and my save game for this one. Another thing I'd like to mention here is if you've got games with multiple versions, that's totally fine because LaunchBox can separate those saves. For instance, we've got Elite Soccer here. If I right click, I've got two versions, the European and the US version. Edit, edit metadata. We're going to head right here to additional apps, which gives us the US version and the European version. If I click on our US version, we've got our save section right here. Got a save right there for the US version. And we've got a separate save for the European version. So this is really awesome when you have those multiple versions combined. And maybe you want to play the European version. Maybe you want to play the US version. Either way, we can actually have saved data for both. And I want to show you how to import. It's actually pretty simple. I'm actually going to import a save that I have on my desktop. So we're going to edit this game, edit metadata and media, game saves, import save game file. And like I mentioned, I've got one right on my desktop here. We're actually just going to go ahead and import it. And with this, we can actually change the name right here. That way we don't get our save files confused. So you can name it whatever you'd like. And you can edit it directly from this window. And there we have it. So it's really easy to back up and restore your saves for your games. And at the time I'm making this video, for these save files, we only have support for RetroArch, but in the future, we will support more emulators. And right along with this, we can create a custom playlist that will auto-populate all the games that we have saves for. And once we add a save to a new game, it'll auto-populate over there. So we're going to head to Playlists. We're going to create a new one. We're going to add, and I'm just going to call this Games with Saves. Auto-populate. From the field, we're going to choose Game Saves. Has any save. That's exactly how I want to set this up. Now, you can set this up any way you'd like, but this will auto-populate the saves and states for us. We'll just choose OK. Now, if we move down here in our playlist section, games with saves. So that playlist will auto-populate new games that we add new saves to. Really nice feature here. It'll definitely keep everything in order for you. The next new feature I want to talk about here has to do with premium users and big box, but this is awesome. We've updated the Game Discovery Center, so now it can access special online lists curated by the LaunchBox team. And if you're not familiar with the Games Discovery Center, we've had it implemented for quite a while now. Something I personally like to use when I kind of get stuck wanting to play something and don't know exactly what to play. From our system menu, Game Discovery Center, and here it is. Basically, what this is going to do is populate different lists. And again, we've had this for a little while now. Some of my favorite sections are the worst of, and we'll move down and take a look at it. But we can continue playing from the top here, recently added. You can go through the platforms if you want to, favorited games, compete for high scores, feeling lucky, best of, and we've got the best of, you know, throughout the years here. Going down just a bit more, we've got what the LaunchBox team is playing. So you can see exactly what's going on over here. But again, some of my favorite were the worst of. So we'll move down all the way. Here's one, worst of 1996. And this is actually really fun to go through and just kind of find really bad games to play for a couple minutes here and there. Maybe get a laugh at the loading screen, just how bad the controls are. But we've got a ton of awesome lists here, like Game of the Year nominee, hidden gems, and so on and so on. This is something that I think a lot more people need to utilize. It comes in really handy for finding something to play. I mean, these are all the games that I have imported right now. It's just going to give me a nice list across the board of everything that I have in case I forgot I've imported something, games I haven't played. I personally really love this big box feature. And the final thing we've added to this new version of LaunchBox for Windows is something that a lot of free users have been asking for quite some time. If you take a look right here, I'm on a free version. I don't have a license installed, and in the past, we would never be able to access Big Box here, but now we've got a 30-minute free trial. So if we go to Menu, Big Box is available only for LaunchBox Premium, but we've got the Start Trial right here. So we're going to go ahead and start it up. This way, if you've been a free user for a while and wanted to try this out, it'll give you 30 minutes to mess around with Big Box. Games and themes are on hold for now in the trial, but this does kind of give us an idea of what to expect, if your system can handle it, how well it performs, and if it's something you'd really be interested in getting. Overall, I do think having this 30-minute trial will help out a lot of people decide in the end, especially if you've been a free user for a while, kind of teetering on the fence. Personally, I've been a huge fan of Big Box for quite some time, and yeah, I mean, it's absolutely beautiful. And you know, with the premium membership, you've got access to themes, all the premium paid features inside of Big Box. But with this 30-minute trial, you can really get an idea of how awesome Big Box really is. But that's going to wrap it up for this release video. We really hope you enjoy the new fixes, improvements, and features for LaunchBox 13.16. And if you've been a free member for some time, that 30-minute free trial is definitely worth checking out. If you've got any questions, let us know down below. And like always, thanks for watching.